This video is about a fun little side project that I did. We are going to have a look at an auto trading bot that is being sold, or actually was sold, to people for the game Guild Wars 2, which is awesome by the way, play it. So a friend of mine told me that this bot has a fun little design issue I should check out, and so that is what we are going to do. Guild Wars 2 Auto Trading Bot is a fully autonomous buying and selling trading post bot for Guild Wars 2. They offer a free trial and it can be run in the background, and obviously it's supposed to make you a lot of gold. They also claim that because it doesn't do any memory reading or writing, like hooking into the engine, that the bot would be hard to recognize by ArenaNet, the developer of Guild Wars 2. And there's a video how it works. You can see you have a lot of different ways to configure it, and when it's running, it will basically simulate clicks in the game as if you would perform those actions. So a very simple bot that doesn't do anything really advanced. Obviously, I don't want to run this binary on my regular machine because I don't trust it, so I'm downloading a free Windows VM that Microsoft offers for developers. First, I want to get some tools I might need to analyze this binary. It's very likely that it will communicate with a server, for example the Guild Wars 2 API, to pull item prices. But yeah, I admit, I already know from my friend that they also have their own server they communicate with. And a great free Windows tool for that is Fiddler. On the download side of the bot, it also says that the .NET framework is required. So I assume it might be a .NET binary, and so I'm downloading .NET Reflector, which is a tool to decompile and analyze .NET code. Okay, so then we can download the bot and have a first look at it. We unpack the archive and we find a couple of interesting files. There is the main .exe, here's a library to parse JSON data, OCR, Optical Character Recognition Library, along with a folder named test data, which reminds me of Tesseract, which is a popular OCR framework, and they probably use that to analyze the text in the game window. And there is a mouse key hook, which they might even inject into the game to simulate the mouse clicks. Well, that would certainly be fairly easy for ArenaNet to identify, though I believe ArenaNet actually doesn't care because fighting against these kinds of things is always an arms race, you just pour in money and cheaters will always find new methods. I think they are clever enough to fight cheaters and botters that have actually negative impact for the game on another level. You will see later that these botters here are absolutely irrelevant for ArenaNet. Okay, so let's have a first run. We start Fiddler and make sure we have SSL interception enabled and then start the bot. Ah, Windows Defender prevented the app from being run, because it's not known. Smart Screen knows the hashes of programs that a lot of people use and trust, and so this is probably an indication that this bot is not a widespread thing. Only a few people use it. Ah, look, there is a first request going out to the Auto Trading Bot website. Check version. And it displays a terms of use prompt. So cute, as if they run any kind of legit company that cares about legal matters. Okay, and then there is a login window, but we obviously don't have a subscription for it. If you try to log in, we can see another request going out to check login data. Canceling the login will start the trial. Okay, so let's do that. It asks us for our API key. Guild Wars 2 offers a JSON API that you can use to query your account's information. For example, there is this amazing site called GW2 Efficiency where you can use your API key to see all sorts of statistics and information about your character. Of course, the bot would use it to look into trading post things, maybe pull the current buy orders or so, and we can click a bit around and investigate the possible features, but we see no new requests so far. Okay, so far nothing too interesting. Like I already mentioned, a friend told me about something funny here, so I know what to look for and we haven't found it yet, so I keep exploring. It has to do with the server they are using. So far we have seen two API requests to the server, but we don't really have a full running bot where we could see more. So let's try to find other endpoints. Next I decide to see what .NET Reflector does with the .exe file. I pull it into here. GW2ATB.exe, not a .NET module? That is not what I was hoping for. Okay, next I download IDA Free 5.0, which can disassemble 32-bit applications. By the way, there is a new version now, version 7, which can disassemble 64-bit. but here I have to use the old one for 32-bit. Then I load the exe into IDA and try to get a first feeling of it. I'm looking for hints if it might be packed or obfuscated, or maybe I can even find already what I'm looking for with the strings. I don't have a lot of experience with Windows binaries, so I have a lot more assumptions and guesses than when I would look at the Linux ELF binary, but I find the patterns up here kind of irregular and weird, and I think that should be a sign that something is fishy going on. And especially because I can't find the auto trading bot website or the API calls in the strings, which we know must be there, is most likely evidence for obfuscation. Okay, let's try something else. Let's start the bot again and have a look at the task manager. We can actually create a dump of this process. I have never done this before, and I actually don't know what it does, but I assume it dumps the process memory. I just knew the menu item was there. And now we have a .dmp file. It's over 300 megabytes, so I assume it's a full memory dump. My assumption is that if it's a basic packed binary, then once the bot is running, all the strings are unpacked and in clear text in memory. So I hope that we can now fairly easily extract strings from the dump. Though I'm a bit unsure about it because I don't know if that's like a raw binary dump or if it's some kind of compressed file format that requires tools. But anyway, next I'm getting a hex editor to look at it, and I think HXD is pretty nice. After installation, just when I thought about opening the dump, I also noticed another functionality of the hex editor. Under extras, you can select open RAM, and then I select the auto trading bot. So we can apparently directly read the RAM, which hopefully contains the unpacked strings. And now we can simply perform text searches in there. For example, we know the API endpoints had /script/ in the path, and so we can search for that. And look, we find instances of that. Here's even the HTTP URL with the check version API call. So it looks like in this general address area, we have interesting strings. So I'm just copying that part into a new file to more easily work with it. I call it now simply memory dump. And then I can write a bit of Python code to extract those strings. And the output file is now easier to explore, and we can search for the API calls. And there they are. There are the official Guild Wars 2 APIs, and there are also the auto trading bot script API calls. And look, we haven't seen those calls before. Set and get online. So we can extract all new endpoints we have found and have a look at each of them. Get online user sounds really interesting, so let's see what happens when we visit the link. But it's nothing. But if you look at the API calls that we know, then we see that they were post requests and included an authentication parameter. So what we can do with Fiddler is we can select one of our previous successful calls and select replay, and we want to edit the request. And then we change the API call to getOnlineUsers.php. And that worked. The response contains all online bots. And the crazy thing is, it returns them with their GW2 API key. This is ridiculous. The bot developers gave us an easy way to track each bot user. Not only the amount of online users, but also gave us their official Guild Wars 2 API key. So we can look up their characters, how much gold they have, what kind of items they trade, their character names, the guilds they belong to, everything. So this was in November 2017, and I've written a script that checks every hour the logged in users and then uses the API key to pull their currently traded items. Knowing the items they are ordering and selling and how much gold they have, I can calculate a liquid net worth of the account and track how effective the bot actually is. So we can see how rich these players are and how long they were active. Now in February 2018, about 3 months later, the bot was actually shut down and is not being sold anymore, which is kinda sad. I had hoped to collect data for much longer time, but at least we got some data. But the video is getting pretty long now, and I would like to show you a bit more, so I create a part 2 bonus video talking about the findings.